generally speaking, I think a lot of shows, most shows exist to reassure people. And I kind of wanted to do something that that would actively unsettle people, because I kind of felt that was missing. I would describe Black Mirror as like a box of dark chocolates. So it's an assortment. You never know quite what you're going to get from one episode to the next, but you know it's going to be dark chocolate. It's a worried show. It's a show that's worried about today. Even though it's often set in kind of near futures or sort of allegorical futures, it's really always about now and what's going on now. I kind of felt that there's a lot of drama. Most dramas tend to be kind of human interest dramas about relationships or, you know, people overcoming great odds, or crime dramas and this, that and the other. And I kind of felt like there weren't many things that were talking about the way the world's changed in the last sort of 10 years, and just everyday life has changed from just you walking around and experiencing the world to staring at a rectangle like that. There's been things where, while writing it, it's been like, oh God, now I'm gonna have to slightly alter it so no one thinks that I'm just trying to do that. In the first series, there's an episode where people are pedaling on bikes to generate power. I think they're just powering the screens that are keeping them dumb in that episode. But then somebody sent me a link to it. There was something similar going on in a Brazilian prison where prisoners were pedaling to generate electricity and being rewarded with sweets or something. No one has blackmailed a prime minister into having sex with a pig yet. It's a little bit worrying how close some of them seem to reality. I hope nothing in this Christmas one comes true, because it's flipping horrible. You look at The Twilight Zone, it's all talking about communism, psychology, space travel, all these things which were contemporary concerns at the time. And that's kind of how that informed that side of Black Mirror, the sort of technological focus or backdrop to a lot of the stories. But having said that, not all our stories are really, like the National Anthem isn't a particularly technological story, it's just about a lack of perceived control in today's world. Another thing that I like about those shows, The Twilight Zone, Night Gallery was another one that Rod Serling did, Hammer House of Horror, Tales of the Unexpected, is that quite often they would end on a devastating note. It was horrible things would happen to people, and cruel punishments were meted out to the character you just followed for half an hour. So there's like an episode of The Twilight Zone where Burgess Meredith is the last guy left on Earth after a nuclear war, and he's a bookworm, and he's going to kill himself because everyone else is dead. And then he sees a library and he realizes that, oh, well, at least I can read uninterrupted for the first time in my life. I can just read all these books, all these great works of fiction I've never had time to read. And he piles up all these books, and he's got something to live for at last. He reaches over to grab the first one, his glasses fall off and smash on the floor, and he's left literally on his knees weeping at the end of the episode. And I thought, that's the sort of thing that should be happening more often on television. The villain is never technology, and I always find it really quite boring. If I'm watching a sci-fi film and there's like the evil genius is gonna, I'm gonna launch this thing, it's gonna enslave everyone, and, you know, it's like, I can't really relate to that. But I can relate to a guy who gets obsessed with the gadget and then it gradually ruins his life. So it's more worried than it is attempting to warn anyone. I don't know, you know, I hope none of the stuff comes true, although a lot of it seems quite close to coming true. Like 2 seconds after hitting the end, it seems to start unfolding in reality, which is quite a terrifying idea for an episode in itself. What I took it to mean was when a screen is off. When a screen is off, it looks like a black mirror, because like any TV, any LCD, any iPhone, any iPad, something like that, if you just stare at it, it looks like a black mirror, and there's something cold and horrifying about that. And it was such a fitting title for the show. It was one of those things that, I mean, I don't know what else we would have called it. Spooky technology time would have been rubbish. So it worked out as being the perfect title in a way, and it's quite, I quite like the fact that people are watching it on, you know, watching it on their TV or on their laptop or their smartphone or whatever, and then when the end credits start running and the screen cuts to black, they see themselves reflected.